Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2285, the new zip code data type in Excel. Well, how many times do you go to the store and at the cash register they say, hey, what's your zip code? What do you do with that information if you are the store? All right, so now we have some new cool tools in Excel. You know, I go out and do seminars and I ask people what their zip code is. So I have a whole bunch of zip codes here and I'm going to try and collapse this down to get a summary by zip code. So insert. Pivot table. I'll put the pivot table in an existing worksheet right here. Click OK. Drag zip code down along the rows area and then sum the numbers. Cool. All right, that's great. I don't need a grand total here at the bottom, so right click and remove grand total. And actually, I don't want this to be a pivot table at all, so I'm going to copy it, Ctrl+C, and paste those values at ESV. And now I just have a regular old thing, a table. All right, instead of sum of number, let's just do total there. All right, I'll make this into a table, Ctrl+T, and this is the new part right here. I'm going to choose all of those zip codes, and on the data tab, declare them to be geography. Now, with over 1,000 zip codes, this is going to take some time, so I'll pause the video until it finishes. Okay, well, hey, that took about a minute, not forever, but longer than you would want to watch in the video. And now I see that there's 16 zip codes that are just flat out wrong. The person gave me the wrong zip code, or maybe it was just a typo, or maybe they didn't want me to know where they lived. Who knows? And I'm going to get rid of these, but I'm not going to get rid of these right now because it would be super annoying to go through one at a time, delete the rows. All right, we'll get rid of them here in a bit. All right, but now that we have the zip codes, check this out. This is a table, so Ctrl+T, and then I can add here the city, right? So now I can see the city. If I needed it, the county, I'm not going to do that today, and then the state or province, like that. All right, now to get all of the error cells, the ones that it couldn't find, like there's no way to sort by that icon, but I can sort by state, and that will force all of the field errors down here to the bottom, right? So if they don't know the city or the state, now these could be valid zip codes, it just spans. Two cities, maybe, but I know where I'm headed with this, so I'm going to take these few records down here and say that I want to delete those from the table. So, home, delete, delete table rows, and we end up with just the items that worked. I mean, that was what, 30 items, and I have 1800 that worked, so that is really cool, right? So, first off, converting zip codes into city and state and county. As well, right? So that's a cool thing. All right, now the second thing I want to do is I want to add a map. I want a map, so I take the zip codes and the totals, and we're going to insert a brand new map type that was introduced in Office 365 somewhere around Excel 2017. So not a 3D map, a filled map chart. And this is going to take a long time because there's 1800 little zip code boundaries that it has to draw, and they warn me here that there are several of these that they couldn't plot, right? And that could be because it's a PO box, and with a PO box there's no shape, right? If it's a point zip code, it's not going to get it, so that 87%, you know, it seems high, all right? So here's, we'll call this Mr. Excel Seminar Attendees. Cool, all right, and you can just barely see the items there, so there's this data is just too large of an area to plot, but what I can do is I can come down here into my table, and because it's a table and I'm in Excel 2013 or newer, I can insert a slicer based on state, click OK, and we'll bring this up here so it's next to our chart, make it wider, number of columns, maybe 3, 4, there we are. All right, so now what I can do is I can click on any state and it will update to show me just the counties in that state. Right click, format data series and map area, only regions with data. I'm not sure I like that. Automatic, all right. There we are, that's good. So we got the shape of Wisconsin. And we can see the counties where I've been. Let's do Texas. All right, you can see I was out in El Paso, Dallas, Tennessee. Sure, a lot of Nashville area, but I was also out in Knoxville, North Carolina, South Carolina. I remember I was in Columbia, South Carolina. So this is cool. This is cool. It shows you for each place a little map of where your customers are coming from. Florida, my home state now. A lot of different areas here along the East Coast and down in Fort Myers, and even Tampa, Alabama. I did a seminar in Mobile and Huntsville and so on. All right, so this is all very cool, being able to take zip codes and get the city, state, and county out of it. And then once you have the zip code as a data type, creating these zip code maps. Very cool bit of functionality here. Now, hey, for those of you who have seen me in one of my seminars, I appreciate you coming out. Maybe you're giving me your zip code, even if it was a fake zip code, I still appreciate having you there. I'm retiring from traveling to these seminars. 35 seminars a year means 70 days on the road. It's just not fun to do the travel anymore. I still love to do the seminars. I'll still be doing the seminars in Florida where I can drive. But otherwise, there are 5 dates left: Tulsa, Springfield, Chicago, Appleton, and Chattanooga. If you've never had a chance to see me, I would love to meet you, have you come to one of my seminars. So click the link down there in the YouTube description for a list of how to register for these 5 last upcoming seminars. Data types are discussed in my new book, Mr. Excel LX, the Holy Grail of Excel Tips. Click that I in the top right-hand corner. If you like what you see here, please subscribe and ring that bell. Well, hey, we'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.